So the NBA recently tested one of their best players and one of my personal favorites, Damian Lillard. So they tested him for drugs after his 71-point game the other night, and I thought we would discuss this. So two questions. One, why did they test him? And then two, what did they test him for? So let's listen to this, and then I'm going to get into exactly what happened.
What was your reaction when you got drug tested?
I mean, honestly, I was like, are y'all serious? Like, I did the urine test yesterday, and then they backed it up with the blood draw tonight after the game. That's actually my first time in my career being tested after a game. And then aside from that, they know that I'm scared of needles. So I know I got a lot of tattoos, but when you're doing the blood draw, it's different than tattoos. But I was, it brought me down from here to the floor all the way until it was done. And then once I finished it, I was like, all right.
All right, so he said they did a urine test yesterday and then a blood draw today. I think he said that was the first time in his career they did that.
I mean, honestly, I was like, are y'all serious? Like, I did the urine test yesterday, and then they backed it up with the blood draw tonight after the game. That's actually my first time in my career being tested after a game.
All right, so the reason they tested him, this is why. So for the month of February, he averaged 38.5 points per game, which is like off the charts and nuts. I mean, 42 points, 40, 33, 38, 40, 39, 71. And he's shooting basically 50% from the field the whole month. And then his three-point percentage, gosh, 41%. So yeah, off the charts, crazy. So when they see a good performance, they're more inclined to test for performance-enhancing drugs. So first of all, he's talked about a urine test and a blood draw. So a urine test, that is always going to be for anabolic steroids. So that's going to be for a lot of different performance enhancers. But what it's not for is HGH, and that is sort of the key there for what they tested him for. So the blood draw, they only do blood draw for HGH. And I'm only saying that after looking at the CBA agreement. And I've mentioned this before. If you want to see it, go to mbpa.com/CBA. And you can see the most recent collective bargaining agreement, which goes over all the details of how they do drug testing in the NBA. So they can only do two tests for HGH in the season and only one during the offseason. And they tell you when the offseason begins and stuff like that. So there's a couple things to remember about HGH testing. One, no one in the history of testing in the NBA has ever been caught or tested positive for HGH. So one, they know their testing sucks. It's in here to scare you off from it, but they know it sucks. They're not going to catch anyone, even if they were to do it. And I highly doubt Damian Lillard even did it. I mean, he said he's scared of needles in the first place. And then two, it's sort of an expensive test. That's not going to matter. But I think this is more like them just checking their boxes off with this. I mean, sort of like a last sort of Hail Mary to see if they can catch somebody. It says two times per season, and he said he's never been tested after a game in his whole career. I don't know if he meant blood draw or not, but you know, my guess would be most players don't even get tested for HGH, especially someone like Damian Lillard that brings in so much money to the NBA. But he definitely got tested for HGH. I don't know if he knows that. It'd be interesting to know if he knew that or not and what his thoughts on that were. He wouldn't care, because I'm sure he's not taking anything. But it's interesting to see when they test players, who they test them, or who they test and why. And I feel like the HGH testing, they might even test other players that don't bring in as much money as someone like Damian Lillard would. I don't know. I just thought it was interesting that he brought this up specifically, because most of the time, most players don't say, I had a urine test, I had a blood test, this and that. And you can look at this CBA agreement and see what all they test for as far as the WADA agreement for what they test for as far as urine analysis and stuff like that. So if you guys have any questions on that or what's in the CBA or what your thoughts are on this, please leave a comment down below and subscribe to the channel. Thanks.